5, 4, 3, 2.
Good morning, Coronado. Welcome to another episode of Cougar TV. I'm Derek Hernandez.
And I'm Olivia Gillum. This year is winding down for us all quickly, especially seniors. For those seniors planning on continuing their education next year, Cougars Care is offering two $500 scholarships. These are needs-based scholarships, and the application is due May 1st to Mr. Urban. A link to the scholarship can be found below this video.
You know, Olivia, I saw proof of alien life in the park last Saturday.
Really? How did you know they were aliens?
How couldn't they be? They're throwing their flying saucers around.
Oh, Derek, those were no aliens. Those were Coronado's very own ultimate frisbee team.
Ultimate Frisbee is a frisbee basically like with a disc that you throw. It's kind of like soccer, kind of like football, but there's 7 players on at a time on each team, and then you go and you pass it, you can't move, and then you score. What attracted me to the game is just it's constant running, and it's very exciting with it's a very teamwork sport where you constantly have to be passing to your teammates. You have to work together, great communication to get the to score, right? And then once you score, it's just a great feeling. We compete every Saturday at 10 or 12 o'clock. We compete against different schools, Palmer sometimes, Air Academy, tons of schools. As of now, we're already midway through the season, so it might be too late now to join, but next season, all you have to do is go down and talk to Mr. Tunnelman, and then he'll get you filled out, and then you can join the team.
It is too late now to join the team, but if you're interested in joining next year, talk to Mr. Tunnelman in room 22.
And now to our sports scores.
Girls tennis got 7th at the Cheyenne Mountain Invitational. Girls soccer won against Woodland Park 4-1. Boys swim placed 4th at the 2019 Spring Classic. Baseball versus Liberty lost 4-6. Girls track got 1st at the La Junta Tiger Relays, while boys track placed 4th at the La Junta Tiger Relays.
As we look forward to the end of April, we may also look forward to the end of this week. Why? Well, because it's Friday, of course, and everyone loves Fridays.
Don't you think you're forgetting something?
Nope. I think I have everything straight in my head. Are you forgetting something?
Nope. And you shouldn't either. Make sure you don't miss the Advanced Acting Showcase coming much earlier this year, seeing as it's this Friday.
Oh, of course. Our very own Too Much Light Makes a Baby Go Blind Showcase. Why don't we take a look at the kind of controlled chaos you can expect to see on stage? The Advanced Acting Showcase is a show style that is based off of One Out of Chicago called Too Much Light Makes a Baby Go Blind. It's 30 plays in 60 minutes where the timer only stops for pizza. I've been doing the AA Showcase since I first got into Advanced Acting, which was my sophomore year, so the past 3 years. So when you come to the door, you're going to go in, get your name tag, and then you're going to go pay. So you'll end up rolling a die, so your price will be anywhere between $1 and $6.
The showcase is on Friday the 26th at 6:30, and the audience should look forward to having a good time and having a lot of laughs, but also seeing a lot of poignant ideas that we want to talk about and bring across to people.
As sports are winding down, we decided to check out how boys swimming was doing.
Let's check them out.
Nice little risk. All right. I think our main goal always is just trying to get as many swimmers as we can to state. It's a lot of fun competing there, and it's probably bigger than the bigger meet than anyone else.
Another goal of ours probably is to get the school record for the 200 medley relay. And we also have a chance of winning state at that event as well.
So we got a lot of new swimmers this year, and we've just been kind of working on getting them better and just getting them into the pool and just getting laps on them. And then we got a bunch of kids who swam before and know what they're doing, so we're just getting everyone a lot faster. And getting a lot faster and just doing the best they can do, which is all we can ask for. So yeah, just state, and then we have Metro League coming up sometime in late April. So we'll be doing that, and just we have a couple more home meets coming out, so just come on out.
Hi, I'm Marco Berryman, and I just started the Coronado swim team. I'm enjoying it so far. I've been to a couple meets. My favorite part about swimming is just doing 50 free, doing flips and turns and diving off the board. Yeah, I just like swimming, so I decided to join the Coronado swim team.
They're really swimming along. Now we take a look at one of the brightest students at Coronado, Jenna Silvat.
That's right, Nat Gia. One could say she's bright as a diamond, or jade, or ruby. I don't know geology, but she sure does.
This is a nice. Okay. So I'm Jenna Salva, and I'm a senior here at Coronado High School, and in my free time, I love to do research. So geology, a lot of people will think, is just only about rocks, and everybody's, oh, geologists are just dumb as rocks, right? Because we're only looking at rocks. But rocks are actually really cool because they can tell stories about what the Earth was like millions of years ago. So for example, we can look at these chondrite meteorites that hit the Earth really long time ago, and those can give us clues about what the chemistry of the universe might have looked like. So we don't realize that minerals, we just look at them and we're like, oh, it's just a mineral. But like quartz, for example, is used in almost everything, from our lighters, from our cell phones. I remember being literally an eight-year-old during the summer, and I went to a summer camp. And during the summer camp, we found these really elusive, kind of mysterious spherical nodules of sandstone. And I remember being so excited because I could tell my camp counselors that these things were actually called concretions. So the project that I'm working on this year is super cool. I'm looking at an alteration halo that is around a diatreme in Cripple Creek. And so Cripple Creek is known for being one of the most famous gold camps that we have here in Colorado, and produce tons and tons and tons of gold. But what I'm interested in is not necessarily the inside of this diatreme, but on the outside. So in a way, looking at this alteration halo on the outside can give us clues about where gold might be outside of the diatreme. So outside of geology, I also really like chemistry. I like to go hiking, I like to be able to go rock climbing, and I also really like reading research. I think that women should definitely be involved in science. I think that a lot of us are discouraged because we see science is mainly a male-dominated field, but as long as you get out there and you show everyone that you can be just as good as anyone else, science is definitely for anyone.
Now, I'm no geologist, but even I don't need the scientific method to know she's a real rock star.
I can't wait until you graduate. Your dry, predictable humor will be missed.
Well, that wraps up another episode of Cougar TV. I'm Derek Hernandez.
And I'm Olivia Gillum.
Stay classy, Coronado!
Oh, I'm sorry. Go ahead.
We're stripping. I mean, we're stripping.
this is for them dare commands.
You gotta stop. You gotta stop.
Respectful, come on.
That was not a-
Not Gia.